Advisors to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention voted unanimously to recommend that people with weakened immune systems get a third shot of either the Pfizer-BioNTech or Moderna vaccine. The vote follows Thursday night's authorization of such use by the Food and Drug Administration. The CDC is expected to endorse the committee's action later on Friday. Providers generally wait for a CDC recommendation on vaccine use, even if the FDA has approved or authorized a vaccine. Immunocompromised people comprise about 2.7% of US adults, or around 7 million people. They are more likely to get severely ill from COVID-19 and they are at higher risk for prolonged coronavirus infection and transmission. They also have a lower antibody response to the initial vaccine regimen and are more likely to transmit the virus to household contacts, according to studies CDC officials presented to the committee. People with conditions that weaken the immune system or who are taking treatments that suppress immunity are also far more likely to have breakthrough infection than people in more normal health. One US study shows 40% to 44% of hospitalized breakthrough cases are in immunocompromised people. Studies have also shown the vaccine is less effective in these people, ranging from 59% to 72%. That compares with 90 to 94% among people without serious immune deficiencies. People who've received a solid organ transplant have the lowest immunity after the standard vaccine regimen. The CDC will further clarify the conditions for which the recommendation is being made once the agency formally accepts the committee's advice. Some of the situations presented to the committee for consideration, which are likely to be officially recommended by the CDC, include: the recommendation is limited to adults 18 and older for the Moderna vaccine because that vaccine has not been authorized for adolescents as of yet. That authorization is expected from the FDA in the next few weeks. The Pfizer vaccine is authorized for adolescents 12 and older and adults. People with other conditions are not being advised to get an additional dose at this point. This would not include long-term care facility residents, persons with diabetes, persons with heart disease. Those types of chronic medical conditions are not the intent here, said Dr. Amanda Cohn of the CDC. Additional studies of how long immunity lasts in healthy people are underway and will determine the timing of any additional doses for the general population, officials of both the FDA and CDC say. The CDC said attempts should be made to match the additional dose type to the one used in the original set of shots someone receives. But if that is not feasible, an additional dose with the other vaccine is permitted. The additional dose should be administered at least 28 days after completion of the primary vaccine series, according to the data reviewed by the committee.